I'm from the Cochrane Institute of Bioscience. Typically, say we use the Institute of Inspection, which transitioned into Cochrane in Norwich. I was going to say some, not to say Norwich, I think Cambridge is caught up. So that's the building that's going up.
To try different methods.
So you've seen things about flipped classrooms. They'll take on all sorts of new things to learn what they need to learn. So we get them to actually use containers and databases. They get to learn, the quirks of what they can and cannot do. And you can start putting in software that actually is often quite difficult to configure, but which facilitates your reproducibility. So things like that they have the Python Jupyter notebooks infrastructure straight on their machine. And Jupyter notebooks, they maintain a huge base in the Docker hub for that reason. We show them Docker hub, and nobody who's got a mobile phone has to be taught how to use Google Play or the iPhone App Store. They're there. And we also show them the advantage of independence, because they see their colleagues who are using a Mac, exactly the same thing as when they're using a PC. And in fact, you've got a big audience there, but basically almost anybody could run the applications. I maintain again, I'm possibly going to have to go to rehab as far as GitHub's concerned. So there's a repository up there. The Docker Hub's all there, and also the Docker files are back at the GitHub. There's two repositories, unfortunately, because of development and production. Thank you. I'm quite happy to answer your questions about why we've got that particular group or what we've used.
So the proof is in the pudding. How many of your students go away and actually write their own Docker files?
I haven't got to that stage yet. Well, we've been working along a route really with them. The main thing is to actually get them introduced to the Bioinformatics tools. So they're learning Bioinformatics as far as they're concerned. We've just laid the first trip through software install. So we're getting to show the horrible underbelly of software installation. So they've been exposed to apt-get, pip, make, and so on. So they begin to see the sort of panoply of different ways that software gets installed. I want to move on to people actually seeing what you do as far as a Docker file and like concerned. So it starts to go down that particular route. They have been using the notebooks, and they like that because we have a fair proportion of PhD students, and it's just be able to just show to their supervisor, this is what I did, here are all the parameters, here's the plot, it's all in that one sort of framework, so that they kind of like that.
And, I mean, there's probably quite a large overlap in the kind of content that you're teaching in other more mainstream sort of academic institutions. Do you have contacts, or it may be worth us talking about that
separately? We've had people from the nearby university of UEA to ask us about this as well, and get access to our materials and contains. It's there. I've made it available on GitHub and .hub. People can work on that and adapt it. I think that's one of the really powerful things about the way Docker's been set up, is that this ability to just build on others rather than just going around that wheel.